Going on, I hope all is well with you guys. I'm Miss Olina. If you guys do not know who I am, of course I am the frustrated Haitian, and I'm here to talk to you guys about an important topic: rice. And of course I'm here to talk to you about rice. This is not a tutorial about rice. I wanted to do this video to actually introduce you guys to the video that I will be doing, which is my rice and peas and coconut milk recipe, or rice and beans, which the Haitians would say, and coconut milk episode. You know you Haitian when you got one of these in your house, right? Yeah, I'm letting you guys in my kitchen. You know you are Haitian when you have one of these mush pilons in your house. But anyways, with that said, I wanted to talk to you guys about rice, because when I do the initial video, I don't want to go on a tangent about the rice. So rice is one thing that is very difficult for a lot of people to cook, because of the fact is that you have to get the rice and water consistency, or the rice and broth consistency, because a lot of people cook it with chicken broth or beef broth or whatever broth, or you have to get the rice and as well coconut milk consistency right. And if you don't do it, you will destroy your rice. Rice, of course, is a grain that is not easy for a lot of people to cook. I'm going to show you two rice that I use to pretty much dummy-proof my system. Again, I'm going to show you two rices that I use to dummy-proof my system. When I first moved to LA, of course, I was used to cooking at home in Miami. Kind of, sort of, not really, no. But, because my mom is a professional cook, she cooks for a living. And of course, she had three kids here in the United States, and she had a husband. So my mom would get off of work and came home and cooked. When I mean cooked, she would cook big pots of food that would be in the refrigerator for at least 4 days. So I grew up looking at her cooking, and not necessarily, because I was one of those Haitian kids, those Haitian females that you can push me in. The more you told me to do something, the more I didn't want to do it. So now that I'm living by myself, I had to learn how to do it, because I wanted to be able to cook the recipes that my mom cooked. So, with that said, two rice that you can actually cook to make sure that you dummy-proof your system. Not all grains of rice are the same. Of course, if you go to an actual rice farm, you will see what an actual rice grain looks like. They put it in some kind of machine after that, which I seen when I was in Haiti, that strips the rice and do all kinds of stuff to the rice that changes the consistency of the rice. So depending on the type of rice you get, you have to make sure that the rice and water portions is the same. I like rice that actually takes a longer time to cook, because pretty much that means that you're dummy proofing your rice. If you get like brown rice takes forever to cook. But the thing is, if you mess up brown rice, the question is, who taught you how to cook? If you mess up parboiled rice, who taught you how to cook? So yes, we're here to talk about parboiled rice and of course brown rice. Parboiled rice is considered to be the Haitian rice. It's considered to be the Dominican rice. It's considered to be like the Puerto Rican, Cuban, Mexican rice. And as you can hear, I named off countries and people. And Mexicans, Cubans, Haitians, Puerto Ricans, Dominicans, we know how to cook rice. And of course, the reason is because we put so much into our rice that we have to make sure that the water and rice and beans and water consistency, oil, all that stuff is actually managed properly. So when it comes to parboiled rice, which you guys will see here, right here, parboiled rice is more of a dense rice. It's very similar to brown rice, but it is actually stripped. Where this rice itself right here takes a longer time to actually cook. It takes a lot of time for the water to actually penetrate it. So if you don't put the right amount of water in here, that means you will undercook it. And when you're done cooking the one cup of rice and two cups of water, the actual rice will still feel like this right here, because you have to get the actual consistency correct. So what I do is that I do one cup of rice and pretty much 2.5 cups of water, or 3 cups of water, because it always, that I have never ever mess up parboiled rice. You know, there's those other rices that are out there that you might find at the dollar store, or the really, really white rice that I've jacked up all the time because, of course, if you put too much water in it, it will mess up. So parboiled rice is a rice that takes a longer time to cook, and it's better to slow cook the rice. Anytime that you cook your rice, do not have the temperature of the actual fire all the way up to like a 5, if that's the maximum that it can actually go to. Put it all the way down to a 2, so the rice can actually slowly cook and the water will start draining. Especially with myself, I put water, I put oil, I put coconut milk or coconut cream in my actual rice itself. Sometimes I just do water and rice and some different Haitian concoctions that I put together. But that rice right there is actually a rice that is very, very easy to cook. And as you can see, this is the one that I actually use. I found this at Fufales. A lot of you guys won't have a Fufales in your area. Fufales, you can find it at Ralph's, Vaughn's. And as you guys can see right here, it does say Mexico on here, because a lot of ethnic people use this parboiled rice. I don't know nobody that's not from the Caribbean that doesn't use parboiled rice, because it's a dummy-proof rice. Now, we're here to talk about brown rice, but we're not talking about just any type of brown rice. I'm talking about brown jasmine rice. I only use brown jasmine rice because I can't stand the way regular brown rice tastes by itself. So, you know, you have that jasmine kick into it, it's so much better. And this is genuine 100% fresh crop brown jasmine rice from Thailand, and this is from Trader Joe's. Trader Joe's right here. And of course, with this right here, I actually wing it. It says right here, bring 2 cups of water to boil to 1 cup of rice. I don't do that because the thing is that the rice becomes, it's still grainy after I'm done cooking it. So I always do 2.5 cups of water to 1 cup of rice. But really, to be honest with you, when it comes to rice, I never, ever, ever do a cup of this or a cup of that. I don't pull a cup and pour it. I pour the rice straight out of here, then, of course, then put the water. It's all eyes. I realize how to work everything by my eyes, because by the time I'm done adding this in, and the time I'm done adding the kidney beans in, and there's, you know, or the black beans in, everything becomes offset. So it's all about eyes. But this right here, which is brown jasmine rice right here, as you guys can see, there's a whole lot of it in here because I'm trying to eat more of this and more of that than the stripped rice. That rice right there is another rice that's very similar to parboiled rice, but it is brown rice. If you know anything about brown rice takes a longer time to cook. And that's a good thing because it's a dummy-proof rice. And, you know, it'll be a good thing because, of course, with this bag of rice, I think I only paid like $3 for it at Trader Joe's. And this is 48 ounces, 3 pounds. And it says a serving of 30, but come on. I'm Haitian. That's all I do is eat rice. So with that said, I will be coming out with the actual video very, very soon. As soon as I'm done with my kitchen. And whew, I wonder how I'm going to do this video. Either I'm going to call one of my friends to help me out, or I'm going to manage this tripod and my SLR right by myself. Yes, I'm going to do it high quality. I'm not going to do a low quality video. I'm going to do a very high quality video. But I hope you guys enjoy this video. And hopefully I'll come back with some other recipes as well. Tell me on the bottom bar what type of recipes you would like to see. And I'll see if I have the time to do it. If you guys don't have one of these, please go get you one of these. I don't know where can you get one of these, but I got this from my godmother who lives in Canada. And she came back from Canada one day to Miami, and she had a whole bunch of stuff from the dollar store in Canada, and she gave me one of those. So with that said, peace out.